Hello everyone, welcome to another Life Protocol video. In this video I'm going to be focusing on the INFPs, and if there's one thing that jumps to mind when I think INFP is overly emotional, and by this I don't mean that they are crying all the time or nothing like that. I just mean that they feel intensely, and of course that's going to come with very good things and also a lot of frustrations and a lot of struggles in their lives. So this is what the video is about. It's about the difficulties that they face due to feeling so intensely. I hope you guys enjoy it, and I'll see you on the next video.
Why it's so difficult to be an INFP? Number 1, is procrastination just another word for lazy? If we take into consideration that INFPs are one of the personality types that are more in touch with their feelings and emotions, and the fact that they are idealists at heart and strive for perfection, then it's safe to assume that might be a hidden reason for this procrastination, that is hiding between the lines. To me, it seems like they might be more afraid of failure, more than actually being lazy. The problem with being an idealist, is that it rarely matches reality. They expect their work to be as well represented on the outside, as it is on the inside. They are very hard and expect too much of themselves. This causes them to worry about not achieving the perfect image they have in their minds. So they delay and procrastinate, and sometimes they don't even engage, because the pain of failing would be greater than not trying at all. Number 2, trouble finishing projects. INFPs are agents of exploration. That's where they feel happy and that's what they gravitate towards, but the constant stream of ideas has a cost, and that cost is not finishing what they started. Getting started is no problem, but their world is filled with possibilities, and as soon as an idea starts to materialize, other ideas start coming about. These new ideas come with a renewed appeal and with another set of fresher possibilities that feel too great to pass on. This cycle then repeats itself over and over. They have their extroverted intuition to thank for this, which manifests itself by consistently seeking out new inspiration. Even though it's not their primary function, it still plays a big role in their behavior. Number 3, too considerate. INFPs can be considerate to a fault. Their idealistic inner world makes them victims to themselves. Because they are true empaths, they do not want to cause conflict or adverse feelings to other people. This compels them to repress their feelings, and not speak when they feel like they should. But like with most things in life, there's a positive and negative side to everything. For example, driving a car can be great, helps you save time, gets you where you need to be faster, and can carry your groceries for you, but it can also get you into an accident or you might hit someone with it. The problem lies with overthinking. If you think hard enough, you'll always going to find the negative side of any situation. A lot of the time INFPs alter their rich empathic inner world, and turn it into their own cage. Number 4, living for other people. INFPs live with a constant worry of disappointing others, no matter who it is. Sometimes it might be just a superficial acquaintance. Maybe they're trying to please a parent, who tells them what profession they should be following, or their friends who tell them they should go out and socialize more. INFPs not only have a tendency to not want to disappoint, but they are very conflict adverse, so in their attempts to please everyone, they lose track of what makes them who they are, and what makes them happy. It's a difficult life when you're trying to make everyone happy, but one thing is certain, forgetting about what makes you you is sure to leave you unhappy and unfulfilled. Number 5, too much emotion. I feel like too much emotion, when talking about an INFP, is an understatement, and by this I mean, emotions are a tricky boat to navigate. For instance, they can experience emotions adverse to the situation. In a joyous occasion they might feel sad, in a winning situation they might feel guilty. Feeling too intensely is also another struggle. This will leave them drained, and recovering from this emotional onslaught can take days or weeks, which in turn will lead to more frustration. But if they had to choose between feeling depressed, or feeling nothing, they would probably prefer to feel depressed, because at least they would feel something. It boggles the mind. Number 6, non-conforming. INFPs are different, just like every other personality type is different in a sense. All personality types have their own specific characteristics and their own way to handle their core values. But none other goes to such extremes when it comes to internal core values or beliefs than INFPs and ISFPs, having introverted feeling as their primary function, makes them extremely value-driven. Although they are conflict-averse and don't like to trouble others, they also don't like to follow the beaten path. So when forced to do something they are not in agreement with, or goes against their core values, they get extremely frustrated. Being forced to pretend to be like everyone else to fit society's norms drives them crazy. They might not show it, or might not be noticeable on the surface because of their gentle nature, but on the inside, there's a storm brewing. The problem is that when they finally express their true selves, the fact that they are so different, and such a small part of the population, that their plights are likely fall on deaf ears, leaving them feeling misunderstood, which will lead to more frustration, and cause them to become more hesitant of opening up in the future. The bottom line: INFPs' high standards cause them to gravitate towards people with values very similar to theirs, or that share the same preferences. Introverted feeling has a way of doing that. While there's nothing wrong with having friends that agree with your ideas, they will not challenge you, or force you to see things through different perspectives. Living in a world of like-minded people is comfortable and safe, but is rarely a breeding ground for development. Choosing the path of least resistance will not take you away from your normal ways of procrastination, not finishing tasks, being too considerate, or letting your idealism paralyze you. Sometimes it's good to force yourself out of your comfort zone. It might be scary, but nothing really changes without some kind of clash. Don't let the world dictate who you are. Instead, show the world how magnificent you can be. You're already an empath. All you have to do is trust your instinct and let go of your worries. If you liked the video, please consider leaving a like and subscribing. That will allow us to keep making more videos like this. For more related content, please click on one of the suggested videos. Thank you for watching.